In this video, we will look at different landscapes and landforms. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Have you ever wondered how the sand you feel under your feet at the beach was created, or did you know that mountains are constantly changing? In this series of videos, you will learn about the landscapes, landforms, and the processes that create them. Firstly, let's start off with some definitions. A landform is a natural or artificial feature of the solid surface of the Earth. Landforms together make up a given terrain, and their arrangement in the landscape is known as topography. A landscape is the visible features of an area of land, its landforms, and how they integrate with natural or man-made features. Individual landforms, when compiled together, are referred to as a landscape. Topographic maps can be utilized to view landscapes. There are many different types of landscapes, including but not limited to coastal landscapes. A coastal landscape is a section of coastline that has a range of coastal features, some erosional, some depositional. It is distinguishable from neighboring coastal landscapes by prevailing characteristics that dominate the form of the coastline there. Riverine landscapes. A riverine landscape is one that has been created by the natural flow of a water stream, such as a river. A riverine landscape is made up of the ecosystems that exist in and near a river. A riverine is also a network of rivers and the surrounding area. Arid landscapes. Aridity occurs where there is a significant lack of available water, to the point of impeding or restricting the growth and development of plant and animal life. Arid climate environments are characterized by a lack of vegetation and are referred to as xeric or desertic. Mountain landscapes. A mountain is a type of land that has risen above the surrounding territory in a specific location. Mountains are made up of rock and dirt. The mountains range in height from 600 meters to more than 8,000 meters. Hills are described as raised ground that is less than 600 meters in height. Karst landscapes. Karst is a form of topography created by the dissolution of soluble rocks including limestone, dolomite, and gypsum. It is distinguished by underwater irrigation channels, sinkholes, and caves. Provided the right conditions, it has also been observed in more weathering-resistant rocks such as quartzite. Landforms within each landscape have distinctive features. In mountainous landscapes, it is possible to have valleys and gorges as landforms. There are certain landforms that can extend across large portions of countries, whilst others may only be features that take up a few meters. Landforms are created by geomorphic processes. These are natural processes that alter the lithosphere to produce distinctive landscapes and landforms. These include constructive and destructive forces. Constructive forces are those that create new landforms or add to those that currently exist. A good example of this is how beaches are formed. Sand is slowly deposited over time, constructing a beach. Destructive forces wear down and damage landscapes, infrastructure, and property. An example of this are ancient ruins that slowly disappear over time when exposed to the elements. Weathering is the breaking down of rocks, soils, and minerals as well as wood and artificial material through contact with the Earth's atmosphere, water, and biological organisms. This can be seen in the spectacular rock formations on the side of these mountains. Another example is when water enters existing cracks within a rock and then freezes and expands. This process repeats itself, with the end result looking like a straight cut. Erosion is the action of surface processes that remove soil, rock, or dissolved material from one location on the Earth's crust and then transports it to another location. Erosion is distinct from weathering, which involves no movement. This is observable on coastlines where arches, caves, and stacks have been formed over many years of erosion. Another good example of erosion is when water moves over the surface of land and slowly starts creating a channel by eroding the rock and soil. Over time, this channel gets wider and wider, whilst also getting deeper. This is one of the factors that helped create the Grand Canyon in the United States of America. Deposition is the geological process in which sediments, soil, and rocks are added to a landform or landmass. Wind, ice, water, and gravity transport previously weathered surface material, which, at the loss of enough kinetic energy in the fluid, is deposited, building up layers of sediment. A good example of this is when the moving water in a river slowly erodes earth and rock from upstream and deposits the material at the river mouth, creating a delta. Lastly, tectonics are the processes that control the structure and properties of the Earth's crust and its evolution through time. There are many tectonic plates on Earth, and as these collide, separate, and slide against each other, over time, they will create some truly spectacular landscapes and landforms. An example of this is the Himalayas. Tectonic shift and volcanic activity can create new and higher ground. However, whilst this is occurring, weathering and erosion will continually bear down on these new surfaces. We can see that both constructive and destructive forces are simultaneously occurring, but at different rates. This will result in ever-changing landforms and landscapes. In this instance, you can see that tectonic shift helped create Mount St. Helens. This is a constructive force, however, when Mount St. Helens erupted, a large amount of the volcano was lost. This was due to destructive forces. Now you have an understanding of the geomorphic processes that help shape the Earth. What are biophysical processes? Well, biophysical processes are interconnected sequences that form and transform natural environments in a cause and effect relationship. For example, erosion, deposition, soil formation, nutrient cycling, and the effects of the weather and climate. Some of these we have already covered in previous videos. For example, erosion and deposition. However, what are the others? Well, let's start off with explaining the difference between the weather and climate, as this has one of the biggest impacts on what a landscape may look like, or the biome on it. Weather is the state of the atmosphere at a particular place and time as regards to heat, cloudiness, dryness, sunshine, wind, rain, etc. For example, how hot, wet, or windy it is at this very moment, in your location right now. Climate is the weather conditions prevailing in an area over a long period of time. For example, a dry, hot desert's weather conditions over a prolonged time will have high temperatures and limited rainfall. The troposphere is the lowest region of the atmosphere, extending from the Earth's surface to a height of about 6 to 10 kilometers. It contains 75% of the atmosphere's mass and 99% of the total mass of water vapor and aerosols. In this photo, you can see the Space Shuttle Endeavour silhouetted against the atmosphere. The orange layer is the troposphere, the white layer is the stratosphere, and the blue layer is the mesosphere. It is important to understand this, because the lowest part of the troposphere, where friction with the Earth's surface influences airflow, is the planetary boundary layer, which heavily influences the wind, temperature, and moisture. This depicts the planetary boundary layer and wind dynamics over the Los Angeles basin during a one-month period. The gray blanket represents the planetary boundary layer's vertical motion. The height of the planetary boundary layer is mostly determined by convection, caused by changes in the Earth's surface temperature, for example, rising during the day and sinking at night. Wind intensity and direction are shown by colored arrows at various heights. You can see that weather and climate are very different, so you now know if someone is using the terms incorrectly. Day-to-day weather conditions vary in terms of temperature, wind speed and direction, cloud cover, precipitation, rain, hail, snow, humidity, and is mainly influenced by the troposphere. However, climate refers to long-term averages. We can look at a place on Earth, for example Antarctica, and say that its climate is that of an Arctic desert. Whereas, the jungles of Indonesia could be referred to as a tropical rainforest climate. Now that you understand the difference between weather, the climate, and how significant the troposphere is, let's look at some of the geomorphic processes covered in the previous video. Weathering and erosion are closely linked biophysical processes, sometimes being so connected that it can be difficult to separate them. For example, already eroded rock can blow up against existing rock and start weathering them. Weathering, erosion, and deposition all play a role in creating coastal landscapes. Ocean currents and tides play large roles in these processes. Beaches can be composed of quartz sands, calcareous sands, which are broken pieces of shells, volcanic, black, sands, or boulders that have been worn down by the constant pounding of wind and waves. This constant barrage by waves is referred to as hydraulic action and helps break down rocks by trapping air in tiny gaps that help break the rock apart. The sand on a beach can be moved along the coastline by longshore drift. This is where the wind will push waves onto the beach at an angle which will then drag sand away from the shoreline. This process repeats itself, and eventually the sand will be shifted along the coast. When looking at riverine landscapes, both deposition and erosion play a large part. Erosion tends to occur in the upper reaches of a river, with deposition occurring further downstream. When a river mouth intersects with another body of water, and the pace of the water slows down, deposition may occur. This is how river deltas are formed. When looking at desert landscapes, erosion, transportation, and deposition occur via wind processes. This results in different dune formations, such as longitudinal dunes, crescent-shaped dunes, star-shaped dunes, and transverse dunes. Karst landscapes are generally soluble rocks that form into caves and underground drainage systems. The process of erosion is quite extreme, and can leave some truly incredible landscapes and landforms. The following image shows the global distribution of major outcrops of carbonate rocks. As you can see, karst landscapes are common throughout the world. Now you have an understanding of the biophysical processes that help shape this planet. Plate tectonics is a theory which outlines the movement of the lithosphere, since tectonic processes on the Earth started 3.3 billion to 3.5 billion years ago. Continental drift, which was established in the early 20th century, is the foundation for this theory. Continental drift is the theory that the Earth's continents have migrated, relative to one another, throughout geologic time, giving the appearance of drifting across the ocean floor. Abraham Hertelius originally proposed the idea that continents could have drifted in 1596. Alfred Wegener expanded on the notion in 1912, but many dismissed his hypothesis. Arthur Holmes later established mantle convection. The theory of plate tectonics, which explains how continents move by riding on plates of the Earth's lithosphere, has subsequently supplanted the concept of continental drift. The lithosphere is the planet's hard outermost shell and contains tectonic plates. Earth's lithosphere contains 7 or 8 main plates, depending on how they are classified, plus many smaller plates. Tectonic plates comprise oceanic lithosphere and thicker continental lithosphere, each of which is topped by its own type of crust. The thickness of the oceanic lithosphere typically ranges from around 6 kilometers at mid-ocean ridges to over 100 kilometers near subduction zones. Continental lithosphere is around 200 kilometers thick. However, this varies between basins, mountain ranges, and continents' stable cratonic interiors. Underneath the lithosphere, the asthenosphere exists. The lithosphere is colder and more rigid, whereas the asthenosphere is warmer and more fluid. As the lithosphere is warmer and more rigid, the tectonic plates float and move on top of the liquid-like asthenosphere. Plate movements can vary from 10 to 160 millimeters per year. The Mid-Atlantic Ridge, for example, grows at roughly the same rate as fingernails, whilst the Nazca plate shrinks at roughly the same rate as hair grows. A plate boundary is the point at which two plates come together. Plate boundaries correlate with geological events, like earthquakes, and the formation of topographic features including mountains, volcanoes, mid-ocean ridges, and oceanic trenches. The bulk of active volcanoes on the planet are along plate boundaries, with the Ring of Fire being the most active and well-known. Divergent, convergent, and transform boundaries are the three types of plate boundaries. Divergent boundaries develop when two plates separate from one another. They occur because of seafloor spreading in zones of ocean-to-ocean rifting, creating new ocean basins. Divergent boundaries in zones of continent-to-continent rifting may cause the formation of new ocean basins when the continent divides and expands. Convergent boundaries arise when two plates slide towards each other. The thick oceanic lithosphere plunges into the less dense continent during zones of ocean-to-continent subduction. An example of this is the Cascade mountain range in the United States of America. Older, colder, denser crust slides beneath less dense crust at zones of ocean-to-ocean subduction. An example of this are the islands of Japan. Ocean basin closure can occur on continent-to-continent boundaries because of collisions between masses of continental lithosphere. An example of this occurred when the Indian landmass collided with the Eurasian plate. This process created the Himalayas and the tallest mountain today, Mount Everest. Transform boundaries occur when two plates grind past one another along transform faults, where plates are neither produced nor destroyed. Along a fault, strong earthquakes can occur. An example of a transform boundary is the San Andreas Fault in California. This is the last video in this series on landforms and landscapes. After watching this video, you now have a deep understanding on what plate tectonics are and how they help shape the Earth. The Earth is always changing, and it will continue to do so.